never cut a tree down, and I don't need to and wouldn't want to, so it's great. And the thing is that the pieces we use, if they've got rock pockets or knots or funny shapes, you know, to timber mills for planking or whatever, it might not be suitable, but for us it's great because it just, you know, it gives more flexibility of the sculptures. I'm Dave Lucas of Lucas Carvings, and then I work with my soon-to-be in-laws, and that business is Woodland Centre, so we kind of work together. I met David and Anne's daughter Heather while I was at university, so it kind of starts with romance. When I eventually met David and Anne, Heather's parents, at that time Anne was kind of getting into chainsaw carving, or had seen it at shows, and actually I think it was for a birthday or anniversary, David, her husband, got a guy down from Scotland who does it and does courses. So he came here and carved a few simple things and showed Anne how to do it, so mushrooms and Easter Island heads. And I happened to be around at the time, and they kind of had an idea of starting a business and said, you know, do I want to give it a go? So I did, and I was actually doing my commercial pilot's license of all things at the time, but that was quite stressful and a lot of money, and I seemed to kind of, you know, show some kind of talent of being able to do this, and people seemed to want to buy my stuff, and it's really just developed from there. So I'll talk to a customer about what they want, and then what I'll do is walk around the yard, it's kind of like a sweetie shop of timber, and pick a bit that I think will work. A lot of people kind of say you just look at a piece and you can see what's in there, but I do have in my mind what it's going to become before I start, and then work with the timber to get the kind of best results. And the thing is with the chainsaws, it's great. So I mean, you can use, like that guy down there, it's got a 4-foot bar on, so you know, I can do huge big cuts to start with and get rid of big bits of timber, but then you can go down to such kind of tiny detail with the small saw still. To start with, it's normally a conversation with either a private customer or you know, a big park somewhere. Really the process is the same, to discuss, you know, ideas, at that point also budget, so I can think, you know, what I'm working with and what I can produce. And once I have an idea, I'll then go and do some research. So if it's an animal, I'll probably actually look up kind of photos and things like that and think how best to sculpt it. And then the next process is I come up with a design drawing. And I find that that's a really good way of showing a customer before the piece is finished what it should look like, give them some kind of peace of mind that it's not going to be completely different to what they're thinking. And I find that if I can do the drawing, I normally can do the sculpture as well. So far, touch wood, it's worked out like that. And I found that when I started sculpting, I would treat the piece of timber like it was a drawing, so very much a cube to start with, and draw a silhouette of something from one side. And then as you kind of get practice, you know, practice makes perfect, you start to kind of think more in three dimensions and think what kind of animals, you know, bone structure and things would be like. And then once the design's been signed off and they're happy with it, then it's a case of selecting the timber and starting chopping. And then really it's just working through with the chainsaws from, you know, the bigger saws to start with, right down through to the small tiny saw and the detail. And then it's the finishing, so I'll you know, sand using a variety of different sanders, belt sanders, random orbital sanders, angle grinders, things like that. And normally the sculptures are just finished to a high quality kind of sanded finish, and then we treat with a preservative, because a lot of the timber's still got some moisture in, so we found if you don't put a preservative on, you can get mold growth and things like that. So that tends to kind of kill off, I guess, the bacteria. And then we'll treat with an oil, anything from teak oil, Danish oil, Osmo oil, things like that. So sometimes I use the blowtorch to get a kind of, well, anywhere from black through to quite a kind of light brown. So you can when you use the blowtorch quite heavily, you get a very kind of charred look, kind of like, you know, coals in your fire would look, and almost a bit of a gloss to them. But then if you brush quite hard with a brush over, you get a really nice kind of matte finish. So especially for things like bears, black bears, it's great. So you just burn the whole body and then thoroughly brush over, and you get this lovely kind of blacky brown, you know, matte finish to it. And then, yeah, it's a case of customer sees the finished thing, hopefully they like it, and sometimes delivery or even installations involved if it's a park. Thank you.
you.